Okay, it's April 22nd in Minnesota. We're going to hiving packages. You can see there's still snow here, so we've had to take some special procedures. So these are the four frames that we took out because it's been rainy, snowy here. We have our pollen patty ready to go to put on. This is our box that will cover our feeder, and of course our inner cover. And way at the bottom, this is our 2-pound package of bees. We also put the entrance reducer in with the smallest opening, and so that's all ready to go. So we have 1-to-1 sugar syrup that we have prepared. Because it's so cold out here, we have it in this bucket that has warm water in it so that it keeps it from getting too cold. So we're gonna spray only very lightly because we don't want them flying around, but it's cold. Take out the syrup can. There'll be some bees on it that you want to leave in there. Next, we're going to take out the queen cage. And you can see there's already comb being made that's attached to it. That's actually a good sign for the bees because that means there are nice young bees in there that are making wax and they're able to build that comb. And we check to make sure that she's alive before we dump all the bees out of this box. So we'll spray just a little bit more on the inside of that cluster of bees. And now we're going to dump them into the hive. Spread that out so they're not in the way of the frames. Then we're going to release the queen, so I'll take the staple out, but don't open your screen until you get it down inside the colony. You don't want her to fly away, so if you open it up down there, she will get onto the comb. So we have the nice, the warm frames in here instead of the cold ones in the middle where we want the bees to be. So we slide these frames to the middle and then we put these colder frames on the outside. That way the bees can come up here and cluster around the nice warm frames. We put our pollen caddy in the center but off to the side so we don't block the hole. Put our inner cover on. We'll put our feeder on. We use the gravity feeder because it'll be right above the cluster. Let the extra drip out. Put that over top of the hole. And then the outside cover, and we're all done.